Maganda umaga po. Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters. Our gospel passage today is taken from Luke chapter 8, from verse 19 to 21. I would like to pay more attention to verse 21, which says, Jesus said to them all, My mother and my brothers are those who hear the word of God and obey it. Let us cast our minds back to the effect and the consequence of the original sin. It broke the relationship between divinity and humanity. The mission of Christ is to restore this relationship between man and God. In the words of Jesus today, humanity is given a new opportunity to be reintegrated into the family of God. Pero we must dispose ourselves in two ways. First, we must listen. Secondly, we must put into practice what we have listened to. This is really so beautiful when we think about it, that Jesus gives us opportunity to become His brothers, His mother, His father, His sisters, His cousins, His nephews. Personally, it gives me confidence that I am no longer alone, but I belong to the family of God. It's not family by blood, but it's family by love. Of course, we know that love is thicker than blood. As we talk about the new family that Jesus has given us an opening to, let us remember that the key word here is listening. I believe personally that listening is an act of love. Listening is an act of respect. Listening is an act of trust. Listening is an act of humility. Listening is an act of solidarity. Listening is an act of self-giving, self-surrender, because it needs our attention. It is important for us to begin to practice this virtue of listening by listening to ourselves. Sometimes we are so busy to listen to ourselves. And I remember what my friend said about that word busy. B-U-S-Y means being under satanic yoke. Many of us are so busy to listen to ourselves, even to listen to our families, to listen to our wives, to listen to our children, to listen to our husband. Every event in our life has a message to communicate to us. Pero if we are not disposed to listen, it will be very difficult for us to grasp the message. So we have to listen to the events of life. We have to listen to our own experiences as human beings. We must listen to God every day. Personally, I'm not boasting about it, but I don't spend a day without opening the pages of the scriptures. I want to listen to God because each time I listen to God, my hope is restored. Each time I listen to God, my sadness vanishes and I experience joy. This is not something that is taught in the classroom, but it's something that we experience through listening. I listen to the word of God every day, at least 3 times every day. Apart from my community prayers, my official liturgical prayers, but I find personal time to listen to God. I want to know what God is telling me in every situation. It's not as if as a priest I don't experience ups and downs, I don't experience turbulence. Whatever another person experiences as a human being, I also experience as a human being. A priest is not someone chosen from among angels, but a priest is someone chosen from among the people. So whatever experience you have, I also have. But what happens to me and what helps me is actually my openness in listening to the word of God. This is my testimony. I lived a life of depression for more than 5 years. The only thing that kept me going was my openness to listening to the word of God. Listening is a necessity in every family. If we want our families to work, we must learn to humble ourselves to listen to one another. As we continue our daily activities today, I wish to inspire you. Do you have any enemy who has been trying to reach out to you and you refuse to listen to the person? A Christian is someone who listens to everyone. Let us pray that we will have the humility of Jesus that listens to each and every one of us. I want you to remember that you are blessed to bless.